Open the eyes of our faith, that we may behold him in all his redeeming work, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Acts. One day, Peter and John were going up to the temple at the hour of prayer, at 3 o'clock in the afternoon, and a man lame from birth was being carried in. People would lay him daily at the gate of the temple, called the Beautiful Gate, so that he could ask for alms from those entering the temple. When he saw Peter and John about to go into the temple, he asked them for alms. Peter looked intently at him, as did John, and said, "Look at us." And he fixed his attention on them, expecting to receive something from them. But Peter said, "I have no silver or gold, but what I have I give you. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, stand up and walk." And he took him by the right hand and raised him up. And immediately his feet and ankles were made strong. Jumping up, he stood and began to walk. And he entered the temple with them, walking and leaping and praising God. All the people saw him walking and praising God. And they recognized him as the one who used to sit and ask for alms at the Beautiful Gate of the temple. And they were filled with wonder and amazement at what had happened to him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let us read the psalm in unison. Give thanks to the Lord and call upon his name. Make known his deeds among the peoples. Sing to him, sing praises to him, and speak of all his marvelous works. Glory in his holy name. Let the hearts of those who seek the Lord rejoice. Search for the Lord and his strength. Continually seek his face. Remember the marvels he has done, his wonders and judgments of now. O offspring of Abraham's servant, O children of Jacob his chosen, he is the Lord our God. His judgment prevails all the world. He has always been mindful of his covenant, the promise he made for a thousand years.
Thank you. Lukaku received service in the last year. Lukaku received service in the last year. Loh papa, loh wete nakla, wakhi adeta, loh mudimine, su dwarta, abime, emaru, hibara, yusle, tu sista, hibara. Loh kolo tale akta maatane, agi kruhe lewa. Loh ta maatane, utolo ta, loh tiko lo ta, kondo, yesu tubo ko ta lo, lebudo. Loh ta kroha me, dito, tu, tinyako. Dosiba, tu leka kamu, dosu dolo duta, dosu taku kuboyi, kita kumure. Dosa misongle u patagani, kutusada dosiba, nela ini ter kuadu nela kutusle ubu, dosa nela nyapa, kama tala mengirpa jiba. Dosiba, mengirpa le, dosa ini siba, tala Sari pun Yesus lagi itu loh. Awalan ini mewi pura semua le aku itu pertama le ramenya do pagyo dalam minyak do. Dari itu aku do pada sinyal beri do. Walau dah do aku do do kuatkan ini hilang do do belajar lagi sinyal do. Do kemudian dia awalan
looking sad, and one of them, whose name was Cleopas, answered him, Are you the only stranger in Jerusalem who does not know the things that have taken place here in these days? He asked them, what things? They replied, the things about Jesus of Nazareth, who was a prophet, mighty in deed and word before God and all the people, and how our chief priests and leaders handed him over to be condemned to death and crucified him. But we had hoped that he was the one to redeem Israel. Yes, and besides all this, it is now the third day since these things took place. Moreover, some women of our group astounded us. They were at the tomb early this morning, and when they did not find his body there, they came back and told us that they had indeed seen a vision of angels who said that he was alive. Some of those who were with us went to the tomb and found it just as the women had said, but they did not see him. Then he said to them, oh, how foolish you are and how slow of heart to believe all that the prophets have declared. Was it not necessary that the Messiah should suffer these things and then enter into his glory? Then beginning with Moses and all the prophets, he interpreted to them the things about himself in all the scriptures. As they came near the village to which they were going, he walked ahead as if he were going on. But they urged him strongly, saying, stay with us, because it is almost evening and the day is now nearly over. So he went in to stay with them. When he was at the table with them, he took bread, blessed and broke it, and gave it to them. Then their eyes were opened, and they recognized him, and he vanished from their sight. They said to each other, were not our hearts burning within us while he was talking to us on the road, while he was opening up the scriptures to us? That same hour they got up and returned to Jerusalem. And they found the 11 and their companions gathered together. They were saying, the Lord has risen indeed, and he has appeared to Simon. Then they told what had happened on the road, and how it had been made known to them in the breaking of the bread. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you.
It has everything to do with Jesus. of us are pilgrims on our life journey. Each of us are pilgrims on our life's For some of us, this journey has been very hard. And for all of us, there have been times when it seemed like all hope was lost. But in Jesus, you can always have hope. The resurrection always comes. And the dark night only lasts for a time. In order for us to experience resurrection, we have to continue walking. We have to not give up hope. And hope is not wishful thinking. Hope is a deep belief that God is with us. In our gospel reading, we hear about two men walking their path. They're confused and upset. They are sorrowing and feel that all hope has been lost. And on that lonely road, Jesus comes to them. But they don't recognize Jesus. Because Jesus comes to them in a way that they don't expect. Because Jesus comes in a way that they don't expect. We often think we know how Jesus is going to appear. But who could have imagined this night? For the people who have come to this country seeking a new life and a new beginning. You enrich our church and our community. And your faithfulness gives us hope. Because you have not given up. You continue to walk. And so we all get to be part of the resurrection moment. A time of dedication. And a celebration of God's work in our midst. Each of us is called by God. And like Mary in the garden, she recognizes Jesus when he calls her name. God is calling your and my name.
Rama.
And with one another. So in this time of resurrection, we celebrate this moment. That we have not given in to the darkness, but that we have continued with love and hope. But this is not an ending. This is a continuation. Because now we continue to see why God has called us together. Each person being here tonight is evidence of the Holy Spirit's work in each of our hearts. And so on this glorious night, let us rejoice. And let us have hope for tomorrow. There will be more challenges. There will be more dark nights. There will be more moments when we wonder, where is God? But because Jesus has come to us in our own journey, our pilgrimage continues. And we know that Jesus will come to us in those dark moments as well. As pilgrims, we are on our way. And we will discover Jesus in our
midst.
Hallelujah, the Lord is risen.
Hallelujah,
the Lord is risen indeed. Hallelujah.
Amen. Well done.
Candidates will now be presented.
We present to you these persons to be elected to the Ministry of Catechists in the Diocese of Central New York.
The words which I command you this day shall be upon your hearts, and you shall teach them diligently to your children, and shall talk of them when you sit in your house, and when you walk by the way, and when you lie down, and when you rise. We will recount to generations to come the praiseworthy deeds and the power of the Lord.
And the wonderful works he has done.
Let us pray. God of all wisdom and knowledge, give your blessing and guidance to all who teach in your church, that by word and example they may lead those whom they teach to the knowledge and love of you, through Christ, our Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
We have crosses up here. close you congratulate with our candidates later. We're going to bless the crosses and we're going to bless cinctures for their albums. The Lord be with you.
Yes. And also with you.
Holy Spirit, we pray a blessing upon these crosses, that they may be a symbol not only of your love, redemption, and resurrection, but also of your calling, that we also take up our cross daily and follow the footsteps of Jesus. May these crosses be a blessing to the wearers and a symbol to all who see them. We pray a blessing, Lord, on these cinctures, that just as we are bound to one another, we are bound to you, and that when the wearers put these on, they will feel a sense of your calling in their lives, and know that you are at work in them, and no matter what challenge they face, you are there to urge them and guide them to hope and empower them. In the name of the diocese, I commission you, Bachway, as catechist in this diocese, and give you this cross as a token of your ministry. In the name of this diocese, I commission you, Edward Way, as catechist in this diocese, and give you this cross as a token of your ministry.
I just want to tell a brief story. I don't really think about the power of the owl. I mean, it's just something that I put on a Sunday. But this past Sunday, we had a gathering upstairs after our Easter service. And when I got into the room, I was wearing my owl. And this little boy came up to me and asked about, could he look for eggs? And he had missed the egg hunt. But he picked me out because I was wearing the owl. And then a little bit later, he had also lost his mother downstairs. And he came to me again, and his little face was sad, and he lost his mother. So there is power in the owl.
There's power in the owl.
There is power in the owl. And so I think that people really look to people in their owls as helpers. And so, and teachers, and all sorts of things. So you're wonderful.
Let us pray for the church and for the world. Grant, Almighty God, that all who confess your name may be united in your truth, live together in your love, and reveal your glory in the world. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
that we may honor one another and serve the common good. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Give us all a reverence for the earth as your own creation, that we may use its resources rightly in the service of others and to your honor and glory. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Bless all whose lives are closely linked with ours, and grant that we may serve Christ in them and love one another as he loves us. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Comfort and heal all those who suffer in body, mind, or spirit. Give them courage and hope in their troubles, and bring them the joy of your salvation. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We commend to your mercy all who have died, that your will for them may be fulfilled. And we pray that we may share with all your saints in your eternal kingdom. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
O Lord our God, accept the fervent prayers of your people, and the multitude of your mercies look with compassion upon us and all who turn to you for help. For you are gracious, O lover of souls, and to you we give glory, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Good evening, everybody. Welcome to Grace Church, Utica, this evening. It's a beautiful evening, and it's just beautiful with all of you here. I'm so glad that you joined us, that we all came together for this really special blessing with Bishop here tonight, and Atwe and Ethel. They are strong supporters, teachers in their communities where they live, and they've been community leaders for many years, before they came to the United States and since, and they really hold their community together. We appreciate their ministry because there's folks in the community that do not speak English, and just like I do not speak Karen, and I'm really not sure what Edwin was saying, except for that I get the English translation in front of me. But it's a blessing when we can offer God's word in a language that speaks to the people who gather. And so this evening we've had things in English, and we've had some Karen, and there will be more in Karen. And so I just hope that everybody can appreciate the gifts of the people that are here tonight, and the spirit, and as the bishop said, the hope. So, with that said, let us offer unto God some of the fruits of the gifts that he has given us. Amen.
Thank you. help thine own and have we given thee.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We give them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
It is right and good and joyful thing, always and everywhere to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. But chiefly are we bound to praise you for the glorious resurrection of your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. For he wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, drink this, all of you.
This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me. Therefore, according to his command, O Father,
we remember his death,
we proclaim his resurrection,
we await his coming in glory.
And we offer our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving to you, O Lord of all, presenting to you from your creation this bread and this wine. We pray you, gracious God, to send your Holy Spirit upon these gifts, that they may be the sacrament of the body of Christ and his blood of the new covenant. Unite us to your Son in his sacrifice, that we may be acceptable through him, being sanctified by the Holy Spirit. In the fullness of time, put all things in subjection unto your Christ, and bring us to that heavenly country where with all your saints we may enter into the everlasting heritage of your sons and daughters. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, the firstborn of all creation, the head of the church, and the author of our salvation. By him and with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we're bold to say, our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Hallelujah, Christ, our Passover is sacrificed for us. Thank you.
Almighty and heavenly God, we thank you for feeding us the spiritual food of the most precious body and blood of thy Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. And as for sure as there is God in us, we are in the universe of the body of your Son, and heirs of your eternal kingdom. And now, Father, we send us out to do the work you have given us to do, to love and serve you as faithful witnesses of Christ our Lord. To him, to you, and to the Holy Spirit, be honor and glory, now and forever. Amen. Live without fear, knowing your Creator has made you holy and has always walked this journey with you. And may the blessing of God Almighty, Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you this day and remain with you always.
Amen.